Hi, so this is the continuation of my tutorial. So I'm just going to load back into the same world where we left off, and then I'm going to see what happens while talking about it. And I'm not going to edit or cut any of this, so you'll see the loading screen as long as I do, because I don't have time nor the software to do that. All right, so we're on the sixth night. Our sanity is a little low. We got plenty of food going on here. We just got a pile of stuff. Now, one thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to make some log armor for when the hounds come. We're going to want to make a fridge as soon as we can, which will be good. And we're going to want to make some chests so we can put our stuff in it. We don't need to put our stuff in it, but organization's always just really helpful. So, I'm going to stay the night here, but I'm going to go over and I'm going to get some monster meat so we can make some meatballs with the food we have. So, let's talk about kiting a little. So, you want to kite everything, unless it's more efficient to tank it, which it almost never is. But spiders, you can just stun lock them by hitting them, if it's one spider. If it's more than one spider, you're going to have to kite them. There's no more spiders in here. If you walk onto the spider web, it'll aggro the spiders. You got to wait for them to attack you, and pull them off the web. If you attack a spider on the web, all the spiders are going to come out. So how we kite is we're going to let the spider try and hit us and move away before it hits us, like that. If it's one spider, you can just beat them up, but if it's multiple spiders, you're going to have to kite the group so you don't get hit by multiple spiders. Ow. So, like, this beefalo, we can kite him if we just let him attack. And then we hit him three times. We just move away from him while he's trying to attack, and he'll miss. And then we can get about three hits, probably around four, but three for safety because we're not wearing armor. I recommend using Control F to kite. And that just got us a bunch of meat and fur and a beefalo horn, so now we can make a winter hat, so that's really cool. So we're gonna wanna do one meat and three filler. So usually vegetables, berries, stuff like that to make meatballs, and those are really gonna feed us a lot. That's why using a crock pot's gonna be really efficient for eating food. Alright, let's think about what we need to do right now. So, we could definitely get more gold, which would allow us to make a fridge, which would be good to put our food in, and that's going to really help with that. We're going to forego making farms with any manure right now, because they don't really have that much of a point. They're not very efficient. But I'm gonna go kill some clockwork people if we can. We're going to look at our log situation. And then tomorrow we're going to be doing a couple harvesting days where we just kind of harvest. Let's stop to get some tumbleweed. Tumbleweed sometimes has some really good stuff in it. Alright, so I don't want him. I want this guy. I want him to come at me. He has a really predictable pattern. So he's going to attack me, and then he's going to run back and do this thing. That's when I attack him. Yeah. Make a fire. Oh! We pissed him off. Now he's going to come. But he killed him, so that's good. That happens sometimes. So for him, we don't want him to destroy the fire. We want to get him over near one of the walls. I'm just going to leave. We have enough gears for now. So I'm going to use my torch fully. I'm not going to blink it because I'm really low on sanity, which isn't usually a problem, but since I don't have armor and I'm low on health a little bit, I'm just going to deal with it for now. And it's raining. Get some manure in here. We can get some of this beefalo wool in here. And that'll dry us off a little bit. The low sanity is not going to be a problem because we can just kite the shadow people. I don't really worry about my sanity. And we can also prototype a lot of stuff if we have to. Typically. So you kite them the same way. You just move away. And usually use Control F to attack. The cool thing about this is I have nothing else to do at night, so this is giving me not only something to do, but I'm also gonna get some shadow essence from it. Oh, he disappeared. I'm gonna plant some pine cones. I wanna plant them kinda around this area so I'll be able to harvest them at night. Later I'm gonna make a tree farm somewhere far away, but for now I wanna put them in this ring so I'll be able to chop them down at night. We're gonna need 2 gold for this and 1 gears and 1 cut stone. So we got enough for the cut stone, but we're gonna need some more gold. So we're gonna go down and get some more gold. Shadows that appear below 30 sanity aren't really that dangerous, because they're so easy to kite. They do a lot of damage if they hit you. But the nightmare fuel is really helpful. A good way to restore sanity is there's a lot of stuff you can eat to restore sanity. One of the things we can eat is we can cook some green caps and eat those. That'll restore sanity. We can also pick up flowers. That'll restore sanity. And also wearing the garland's gonna increase our sanity, so just pick up a couple flowers, and that'll make our sanity above 30. These ones are a little faster, but you really kite them the same way, as long as you're moving away from them when they try and attack you. Like that. As I said before, they're not really that dangerous. It's kind of a waste of time to be dealing with this, and time's important in this game, so... Ooh. Don't want to get hit again. And you gotta watch out, because sometimes they can kind of spawn right where you're standing when they teleport away. We can make some butterfly cupcakes later, which are very easy to make. We want to take the road for speed. Your health and your sanity aren't really that important, I don't think, early game. Later game, you're going to have plenty of food, so you'll be dealing more with health. But right now, I'm not really worried about it. We're going to let these petals spoil because they'll become rot, and we can use rot to fertilize. Rot and manure are really good fertilizers. Manure is really easy if you're near a lot of beef flow, and rot is really easy because you can just pick flowers and let them spoil. I try not pick flowers around my base because I want butterflies to spawn on those flowers. And now we got enough gold, but we're going to get a little bit more for some other stuff. We want to make a bird cage, and that's going to take some gold. But it's going to also take some other stuff, so we're just going to get a little bit of gold for it. You want to watch out for tall birds because they will kill you. Ooh. I seem to have pissed this one off. If I walk far enough away, he'll stop following me. Watch out anytime you go on marshland because tentacles can spawn and they can attack you and they can be very dangerous. You'll watch. You'll see like little ripples. Getting some flint. We're gonna need a little bit more sticks so we can make stuff. I try and always have at least enough sticks and grass for a torch. Need a little bit more gold. There we go. That's good. Now I'm gonna go back and maybe we'll make a fridge, which is gonna store a lot of our food in it. It's going to be a little bit harder to find gears if you're not playing Reign of Giants because there will be less clockwork biomes. So you want to watch out for that. If you're playing Rand of Giants, it should be pretty easy to find Garrus. There's clockwork biomes, all kinds of places. Oh, and I just got this mini-map up here. We don't really need a mini-map. I use the mini-map so I can try and make sure every time I'm walking someplace, I try and not walk in a place I've already walked so I can reveal more of the map. Unless, of course, you're taking the roads to be faster, in which case you usually do that. It's kind of a luxury to be revealing more of the map. So we're going to get back to our base. Tomorrow we're going to chop a bunch of wood. Because we'll need that to make some chests and start organizing some stuff. We got some sticks here we can pick. We'll pick them at night. And right here we want to make some cut stone. And then we can make our fridge. I usually try and make my fridge right near the icebox. That way you can have it open and be working in that at the same time. Alright, now I want to cook the meat. When you cook something, it's going to reduce the spoilage by half. So this green line will go about halfway up. But meat lasts a lot longer cooked. It'll last a lot longer dried, but I don't really have the resources to dry it right now. So I'm not going to. But we're going to make those pretty soon. And we don't really have any beefalo fur to put on this fire, so I'm just going to use some logs for now. Though usually I'm going to try and get some beefalo fur in a couple of nights. And we'll start using that so we can save our logs. Depending on how much grass you have, you can also make grass rolls. Where is it? Grass straw rolls are more efficient than just using cut grass because the one rope makes it 9, and that 9 cut grass wouldn't give you the same that the roll would. So I got some of this. I'm going to organize some of my inventory so things are where I like them. I'll put these petals on the floor. They'll spoil faster if they're on the ground than your inventory. And tomorrow we can go get some food and some stuff. We're a little low on food, but it's fine because we can just eat. I'll get some butterflies. We can cook these. They'll restore sanity at the cost of health, but it doesn't really matter right now. The great thing about the butterfly cupcakes that we're going to make is that you can use logs as a filler or twigs. So you can turn some of your non-food items to food. And we're also going to go get some berry bushes and stuff. So we're going to want to try and get a bunch of berry bushes tomorrow. Because that'll provide us with some food. We can get logs another day. I just try and drop all my stuff. When we have the time, I definitely make a chest for everything. I really like to keep organized. It saves a lot of time when you know exactly where to get your stuff. That. On the way, we can eat butterflies for food. When we see them, they'll give us a lot of health eating raw butterflies. You can also make the butterfly cupcakes, the butterfly wings, vegetable or fruit, and then just some filler, usually sticks or vegetables, depending on what you have on you. We'll take this carrot, take some berry bushes. Eye plant. The lure plant will, these things will eat items, so you want to steer clear of that. We can kill it later. It's kind of in the way, it doesn't really do much. They can sprout up anywhere, so they can actually sprout up near your base and start eating all your items, which can be stressful. Right here, we got a camp that's gonna become a walrus camp. There's gonna be an igloo on that in the summer or winter. Ooh, so we got some graves here. Those are good. We don't want to dig mushrooms ever, because if we dig them, we ruin the spawn. And here we got the metal potato thing. Once you assemble all these together, you can warp to a new world, which will be like the same as your world. Where did that butterfly go? We'll just press Control F when he's hovering like that and get the butterfly. It's pretty easy. I was clicking on him before because my mouse wasn't set right, but I fixed it. And you always want to pick these mushrooms. All these graves, these are great because they can have a lot of good stuff in them. Gems, trinkets. Trinkets you can trade to the... Oh, wrong button. You can trade to the Pig King. We're gonna get back. Ooh, nope. So I can eat. Now that we have meatballs, and we have that spider den really close, we can turn monster meat into meatballs with 3 filler, and we just can't use sticks. But that's fine, because we can get all kinds of other filler everywhere, and it'll be great. As long as you don't use sticks. You don't want to use more than one monster meat in a recipe, because if you go more than 2 on the monster meat, or durians, you're going to get monster lasagna, which isn't very good. I usually don't kill beefalo that early because I want them to grow in their numbers, but I kind of had to do that. I just eat these seeds. Cooking seeds doesn't really make them that much better. So we do this. And we can hear that the hounds are coming now from that noise that they just made. You don't want to use the space bar when you're holding a shovel to pick stuff up. Oh, wet goop. I don't know what I'm doing. It's probably the wrong recipe. Should probably play this game more. So, I'm gonna put this on the floor so this rots too. And I'm going to suit up for the hound attack. So we want to kind of kite the hounds a little, but you can kind of just tank them if you really want to. Get all nice and wet. There we go, we got a butterfly. This is going to restore a lot of health, which is good. And we can also use twigs for it, which is great. And we'll be able to use these mushrooms as vegetables. So we got plenty of vegetables and plenty of meat right now. And this grass will protect us from the hounds. So you just move away, hit. Move away, hit, hit. Move away. Hit, hit. There. It's like that. And they'll come at you periodically like this. There'll be more and more hounds as time goes on. So it can get difficult to kite all the hounds at once. Let's open this. 3 filler and 1 meat. We'll make meatballs. Kind of getting wet. If we find a pig, we can kill him to get And now this is upgraded. There's more spiders. So you just want to get close to them, piss them off, and then we'll go beat them up like this. Another spiders will come. Okay, so this is what we don't want to do. We want to kind of kite them, like hit once, and then back off. Until there's enough where we can stun lock them. Like that. I don't really have much stuff to burn. For a beginner, I recommend that you always are at your fire pit when night falls. Me, I don't really care. And these hands, when you're low at standing, will come. You can just move them back like this, and they'll eventually disappear. If they're not disappearing and they're out of your light range, you just have to take out a torch real quick. So now we cook some of this meat. It's going to take rope, twigs, and charcoal. Get some more nightmare fuel. If you're playing the base game, these meatballs won't spoil. Oh, man. Not paying attention. They won't spoil while they're in the crock pot. But if you're playing Raid of Giants, they will. Getting wet really reduces your sanity. The best way to prevent getting heavily wet like this is to make an umbrella, which I don't have right now, so I'm just not going to worry about it. You can also dry off near the fire. Put these in here. When the beef aren't in heat, we can go shave them at night. Get some fuel for the fire. Right now we need some logs. So I'm gonna go get some while I kill this. You're gonna have tons of nightmare fuel. If you're a beginner, I don't recommend just going insane and then fighting off all the creatures. But I've just had games where I just don't do anything for my sanity and just go insane constantly. And it usually works pretty well. You kite like four of these at once. Ooh, that was bad. Uh-oh. Gotta be more careful. Yeah, if you're not careful, these guys could take you out really fast, even if you're wearing a log suit. So it's important to be careful. She's probably not listening to me. I mean, like, this isn't the best run, but, I mean, if you get one or two tips out of watching it, then it's worth it. So, I'm not claiming to be the best, or even really that great at this game. I just kind of casually play it. Probably want to get some butterflies for some butterfly cupcakes at this point. When I start prototyping stuff, my sanity will shoot back up. so I'm gonna dig this. Usually don't want to dig it, but I want to get some sanity so I don't die to the shadow creatures, because I've been just being super careless, just getting beaten up by them. Just getting abused by them. Not a good idea. It becomes difficult a little bit with these really short days. To get some stuff done. So three boards together like that, and then we'll be able to make a chest. And we don't have to make chests, but I really like keeping things organized. And it'll help if you play Shipwrecked, because you're going to need a chest in Shipwrecked. And I like things being on the ground. And there's certain things like ash that you can't really put on the ground. I'm going to leave this on the ground. We really haven't gotten much done in these past couple of days, kind of just like surviving. I usually make a bunch of chests. We did the hound attack, they're not going to come for a little bit. Don't want to chop these trees down right now. We killed a bunch of spiders, so we can basically survive on the monster meat. We don't want to attack them on the webbing. That will anger everything in the nest, and they'll all come out, and they'll really come at you. Ooh, that was weird. I guess I'm lagging a little. Or maybe I just walked into his hitbox a little too soon. This would be a better tutorial if I didn't constantly mess up. We can make some rope. We'll take some of this. And then we can make a drying rack. We'll build them a little bit over here. The drying rack's great because it's going to be able to dry meat. And it'll turn into jerky. And jerky lasts so much longer. We'll make a field of drying racks eventually. But right now, we don't really have a whole extra resources to do that. Just try to make one thing at a time. Keep making stuff that you need. And it's a full moon, so we can go. It'll be a full moon for two nights. We don't have to worry about light. We can go do a bunch of stuff at the middle of the night. Seeds. Probably want to restore some life. This run could end early. Let's hope it doesn't. Tomorrow I'll harvest some butterflies. You could also get some honey and make some honey ham. But that's probably pretty risky when I have 8 life. Really, right now, I just want to make a ton of chests. This is what I want to do. We got drying rack. We can make some drying racks. We're going to make a bird cage pretty soon. We can go to a swamp and get some reeds to make some paper to make a bird cage. But you can pretty much survive with just a crock pot and fire. We're going to want to make a nice warm winter hat, too. We already got the beefalo horn for that, so we're already pretty much done. And we'll just take some more saplings back. We want to kind of grow our field a little bit. Ooh, come on. This butterfly needs to stop moving. There we go. Two butterfly cupcakes. Some more grass. Stop moving. I want to make use of the day getting the butterflies because they go back into the flowers at night. Oh, come on. It's one smart butterfly. There we go. If you get them towards the top of their twirl, they'll just leave. Yep. Like that. Floats out, nice. Yeah, man. There we go. Got plenty. That'll heal us up to full. I try and get them when they're at the top of the arc. If you click when they're at the top of the arc, they'll go down as you run towards them. Yeah. Well, that's cooking. I'm gonna go get some manure to fertilize. I'm gonna stay clear of those spiders, seeing as if they hit me, they'll kill me. And I wanna stay clear of beefalo. If they're in heat, they'll also kill me. It's kinda hard to tell, but if you can see, their butt will be red. You don't wanna move towards them. See, he was in heat, he's pissed. I want to avoid all things that'll kill me right now. Until I get my health back up. And then I can be careless again. We'll be able to make a log suit, which is great. So we're going to pick up this manure. There's not that many beefalo. They'll mate, and then there'll be a billion of them, eventually. If you get over day 100 and you don't really kill many beefalo, there can get to be a lot. See, his butt's red. That means I want to stay clear of him. He'll just go attack. I can reap the reward of him killing all these spiders, so. Just want to keep my distance. Since I really want food, I'm going to fertilize these. Oh, man. And make more. Get healed up to full. In no time. I'm gonna place more chests. Make some more wet goop. Maybe that'll help. You can always check on the wiki if you want to find the recipe for anything. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. It worked last time. Let's see this. This works with just... Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing wrong. It's not the right recipe, clearly. If you look on the crockpot section on the wiki, it has all the... what you need for all the recipes listed. It's quite detailed. Oh man, this is such a bad run right now. Where's my grass suit? Continuously going insane. Ooh. It's a little harder to maintain your sanity when it rains so much too, because you constantly get wet, especially early in the game. That doesn't happen so much in the base game. Fine then. What do I want to make? I'll use this to heal. I'm gonna get all my stuff in chests and just keep them there. Alright, so next we want a birdcage. Birdcage is really important because birdcage is going to allow you to convert monster meat into eggs, and then you can use eggs and monster meat to make either bacon and eggs, or you can also do meatballs with it. And that's really great because that means you can just survive on monster meat alone. So during the winter, or if you're having trouble in the summer, getting away from your base or whatever season, you can basically just survive on monster meat. So if you're near a spider nest, you're golden. Alright, so we got some rot. We take that rot and we fertilize our berry bushes with it for more food. Get about 4 more berry bushes. That's going to be a good amount of berry bushes. You can get a real lot of berry bushes. They won't help you during the winter, though, so... Uh-oh. I need another spear. Hey, come on. One of the negative parts about using Control F is you sometimes hit the wrong thing. I would just make rope right now and then make the spear. I'm trying to be careful so I don't get hit. Because I don't want to be back low on health again. There we go. I'm gonna have plenty of nightmare fuel though. So that's gonna be good. So now we got quite a bit of life now. Thanks to all the butterflies. Still soaked, still losing a lot of water. Not very good, but oh well. So what I want to do is I want to find a Mars so you can get some paper. So I'll probably go a little out that way. Plant some more trees. So we'll be able to cut those down for some wood. Another thing you can do if you're want to stop going insane is you could just prototype stuff that you don't really need. Like I could just prototype a sign like that. Just you don't have to put it anywhere. You can just right-click and prototype like a hay wall. And I can just burn these if I want to. That's a good way to get out of insanity real fast. And you want to watch out because slightly after you are done going insane, some of these things can still attack you. If we use 3 meat. Not monster meat, but 3 meat. You can get meaty stew. It spoils fast, but it's worth a lot of points. I apologize if my voice is a little off. I'm very sick right now. I have no idea why I'm doing any of this. Alright, and we got enough logs, so we can just kind of go at it, we can just piece, and we'll be able to make a fire overnight. I'm going to plant these saplings so they're not just in my inventory, and then there'll be twigs when I get back, hopefully. Try and keep everything organized. You can get mods to make everything easier to place, but I just place it like that. Now we're going to go exploring. We don't really have to worry about the next season for 15 or so days. It's around day 16, 18 that you really gotta start worrying about winter / summer. If you're not playing Reign of Giants, then you have to worry about winter, which isn't that difficult. You have to worry about summer if you're playing Reign of Giants, if you're in spring. I think summer is a lot harder. There's much harder to get food in winter, but the easy part about winter is that in winter, your stuff doesn't catch on fire for no reason, which can happen in summer. The overheating can smolder some of your stuff, and if you don't put it out in time, it can set on fire. And it can set on fire while you're approaching your base, which can make it really difficult to stop. I'm gonna gather food as I go. Trying to explore new areas. I'll try and put my fire as far as I can. Ooh, here we are. So this eye bone, if you pick it up and you have it in your inventory, Chester will come and follow you. Chester is a great find. Ooh, gotta watch out for the hands when you hear that music. See, I use my torch to get rid of it, because it's way back there. put this in there. A little bit extra. And now that I'm not wet, my sanity's not going to be dropping nearly as much. Put the berry bushes in him. Oh. Don't want to hit Chester. That's another thing. Control F is indiscriminate. And Chester can die, but if Chester dies, he'll just come back in a day. Good as new. He might be a little upset, but... I mean, so's life. I'd be a little upset. The meaty stew is going to give us a lot, so we're not going to really worry about it right now. Put some of our extra stuff in Chester. Chester will just follow you around. He's really great. Okay, so we got some more gold, some more berry bushes, which is good. We really want to find a swamp. Okay. This is a good fishing spot. We can get some trinkets from fishing here. That's Wally. He will insult you. And he also has an interesting riddle to solve. Alright, so we got... want to avoid these killer bees. They will mess us up. We got more clockwork monsters, which is cool. It's raining again, which is stellar. And this is Maxwell's door. That'll take you to adventure mode. So you want to kind of just keep track of where that is. Bees are killer bees during the spring, so you want to watch out for bees. They'll be very aggressive towards you. I don't know what time we're at for this video. It should probably end pretty soon. So I just want to explore when I can and really just get as much of the map reveal as possible. You want to find the things you need to find. We got Chester now. We got plenty of food. We'll be able to fertilize those bushes, and you can just pick them in the extra food. If it spoils, it's fine because it becomes rot. You can use it to fertilize. Sometimes you can pick petals. If you really want extra rot, you just pick petals. Usually try and pick them away from my base, and then we'll be able to use those as rot when they rot. Just leave them on the ground near your base. And then you can catch butterflies after you make a bug net. And that's going to be able to catch live butterflies instead of dead ones. You can plant them as flowers, and then they'll generate butterflies. So you can make like a bunch of flowers next to each other, make like a butterfly biome. You're gonna have all kinds of food when you come back to base, and we're still good on food because we're just gonna eat this meaty stew when we need to. I have kind of enough berry bushes right now, so I only really want one more. And then I'm just going to pick the rest of them. An abundance of berry bushes, it can be good, but it's not really going to help that much past a certain amount. We'll just have tons of extra berries, which can make extra rot. It can be kind of useful, but I just leave them, so that way when you're adventuring... be more berry bushes. Also, if you have an accident and everything gets set on fire, you don't want all the berry bushes in the world to be on fire. We're going to lose a lot of sanity now because it's raining again. We really want to find a pig. If we could find a pig, we could make an umbrella. That would stop all this insanity from raining. You also, if you're in a Reign of Giants, you can just make a pretty parasol. I usually just don't deal with being insane, but that's how I like to play. You can play however you want. I'd recommend not playing like that if you're new, and if If you're not new, I would recommend playing like that because it's the best way to play. Just constantly fighting off, going insane. Or purposefully going insane. I'll make a petty parasol with this to demonstrate. Because it's really pouring out. And here we got the ring thing. That's one of our things we want to warp, which we'll eventually do. Warping is great because you can eventually get to the point where you're kind of done most things you want to do. Alright, and we got right here the set piece with a dead guy, some gold, and a miner hat. Which is really nice. The miner hat's going to allow you to walk around at night. And we'll take this pickaxe too. And the petty parasol doesn't come. Wow, I need to stop getting struck by lightning. So the meaty stew will almost completely restore that. The petty parasol isn't perfect, so you can still get wet, but at a less rate. But if it's just raining forever, like it is now, I mean, I'm gonna go insane again. I really just want to find that nice swamp biome, so I'm gonna go down here and look around. And this spoils. It doesn't have durability. What you can do is you can make a building, and then if you right-click, you don't place it, but you store it. You can store all kinds of buildings, like we have the stored sign. Getting a little cold because of how wet this is. This is more like a let's play at this point, but I guess I'm still going to talk about what I'm doing and why. So, like, if you want to watch this, it can at least be somewhat helpful. Could store some of the stuff we don't want. Oh man. Oh yeah, and when you're super wet, your stuff will fall out of your hands. It's not nice. It's no fun. See. I'm just soaked right now. Try and dry out a little. Make a really big fire. You want to watch out with the campfire, because the campfire can spread. So you don't want anything flammable next to it. This will drastically reduce our water sitting next to the fire like this, which is going to make us sane again, hopefully. Because we're going to be expecting some hounds pretty soon. Pick up some of these. Die. Probably want to wear armor when you do this, because they do a lot of damage. Not having armor, they can almost one hit you. Like, that could have been worse, and I would have taken a lot of damage. It's just unnecessary not wear armor. I just don't want to leave my backpack, so I'm kind of traveling while I do this. on. Yeah, my Whitechester. It's a weird shaped world. Dry off a lot slower away from the fire. But I don't want to stand all day waiting around. We don't really need gold right now. What we do need is some reeds to make a birdcage. Birdcage will help you survive. So it's still wet. Which means it's still going insane. Yeah, we're still kind of in a good spot. We have plenty of gears around. We're going to make an ice fling-o-matic for the summer. We'll need ice for that, so. And start to harvest some ice sometime soon. This is a big rocky biome. It's a lot of gold here. Ice will last forever in the icebox. Man. And there we got a... That's a fully evolved spider den. There's a lot of fully evolved spider dens. It's a lot of spiders. This is a lot of spiders. So the spider den, once it's at 3, like that, with 3 tiers, it's going to have about 15 spiders in it. And eventually it will evolve into a spider queen, get up, and start walking away. And leave a level 1 spider den behind. The spider queen will drop her spider hat, which will allow you to control spiders at the cost of sanity. And it'll also drop... Man, I'm still going crazy amount of insane. She'll also drop an egg sack that you can plant in a spider's den with. So you can kill level 3 spiders then and then replant them as level 1s, which will be great. So later when that's level 3, we'll kill it and we'll put it somewhere else. So we can start supplying our spiders, control them, put them wherever we want, we can put them behind walls if you want. It doesn't really matter. I try and like make a quarantine off area with a bunch of spiders' dens. Doesn't look like we're really getting anywhere. I feel like this is kind of the end, so we're going to go back up here and try and explore more. Got this really, really nice, convenient wormhole. Gets you all the way up here. Got more rot. Hey, come on. Behave. Uh-oh. I'm lagging a little, you can tell. Six rot, nice. It's really hard to do this with my frames is pretty low. Come on. Ah. Get him. All right. Fertilize more. Oh, we got some berry bushes here. Ah, man. Come on. Or we could just get Chester. You just kind of walk over this way. Ah, he's sleeping. That's all right. Get him the eye bone. He'll wake up and follow us. Or not, I guess. Yeah, come on. There we go. And we can make him stationary by putting that in there. One thing we want to make is some log armor. Log armor is going to be a little better. And grass armor, and we could just throw that on fire. I don't care. Don't need any more. So all in all, pretty good right now. Got plenty of bushes. Going to plant these bushes. Got plenty of twigs. We can fertilize that, probably. Probably want to fertilize the grass first before these extra bushes, because we got so many bushes. Click like three times before it works. Make some butterfly cakes. Butterfly cupcakes, vegetables. I don't always use twigs for filler. Sometimes I just use food, especially when you have an abundance of food. So that's it for now. A lot of kiting shadow creatures, failing to kite shadow creatures, all sorts of stuff. We got our ring thing, this, made some cakes, we're going to heal up. A lot of exploration going, trying to explore more areas next. I will normally make about 2 ice boxes, because I'll have enough food to be filling 2 up. But right now, it doesn't really matter. And I'll heal myself with these butterfly cakes. Oh, man. It's just raining all the time. The rain can be quite difficult, but It's not a big deal. The best way to restore large amounts of sanity is if you either use a tent, which we can't build right now because we don't have enough cobweb, or you can make taffy from honey. So we could build the tent if we had a little bit more cobweb. No, we'll use the monster meat because it'll spoil faster. Make a bunch of meatballs. And we can make this with the fur once we get it, which you can just get from shaving beefaloes. There's a lot of different dress items. And after I have enough chests for basically everything, what I do is I categorize everything. So I'll have like rock, gold, flint, all that kind of stuff. And then I'll have like grass, twigs, logs, all in the same chest. I usually drop tools around my campfire so that I can just pick them up on the go. And I usually keep my logs in my backpack, so when I pick it on, it'll just drop my backpack. Like that. I want to have flint, grass, and that on me at any time. Usually some logs, depending. And then some food, twigs, torch. Keeping a torch in your inventory is a great way to not die at night. I find a lot of new people will just die to Charlie a lot. I've only ever died to Charlie once because I almost always have these three stacks in my inventory, so I can always just make a torch if I have to late at night. And we can cut at night. We'll be able to cut this firewood. It's really important to try and stay busy, so I try and at night do stuff. Like, that's why I'll plant these trees close. And later, when I have more resources, what I'll do is I'll go make another place with trees, and I'll put some pig huts next to it. That way, I can hire some pigs by feeding them meat, and then cut all the trees. And I'll usually put a couple lanterns and then some other stuff near it. Put this here, and then I'll put a chest right here. You don't have to worry about campfires spreading, and I'll put all my flammable stuff in here, so that way when I need to go get some flammable stuff real quick, I'll know it's all in here. We're just gonna keep all this in here until we need it. Now we have food for 4 or 5 days going on. So see, now that we know this, you can just take this out. Put that back. Like that. So this has been fun. A lot of kiting. But I'm going to have to turn it off now. We'll be going to day 15. Hopefully we'll get a lot more done. There's a couple more things we want to do. We want to start making like a tooth trap field for the hounds. It's not the best way to kill hounds. It's not the most innovative, but it's a very easy way to do it, and it's very effective later on. We're going to make more drying racks. Probably make a bird cage. Make some bird traps to trap bird. We probably want to make a press the hat and a shadow manipulator. What I like to do is make a couple extra backpacks and fill them with material that I'll need on the go in case something bad happens. We can also make some bee boxes. And then we can also, we'll find the glommer down here on our next run down. And we can kill him during the next full moon. And we'll be able to make an old bell. And then we can make a meat effigy to make sure we don't die. Alright, I hope you had fun. I didn't have that much fun making this, but it was alright.